Dear class of 2020, it is with great joy that I join with you tonight to offer the invocation at your graduation. And even though it might be a virtual graduation, it is real. It marks the real accomplishment of your academic pursuit. It marks the thirst for knowledge and the work that you have done to get to this point. And as much as it marks the end of your time here at Our Lady of Grace, it does mark the beginning of something wonderful and new. Before I give the invocation, I'd like to just take a moment to address your parents and our faculty and staff. Dear parents, I'd like to take this opportunity just to thank you for entrusting your children to us so that we might teach them the values and the faith. Catholic education comes with a sacrifice, and I thank you for willingly shoulder that burden. The children that they were have now become young adults, and it is with great joy that we are able to celebrate this moment, and I want to thank you for allowing us that opportunity. Dear faculty and staff, Ms. McManus, your teachers have been awesome. Thank you for all the work that you have done through the years, but especially during these last few weeks that have been very difficult and demanding. In the moments when you might have thrown up your hands and not know exactly what to do or what to say or how to Zoom, I just want to thank you for your constancy and your willingness to continue to teach. And if there was ever a doubt, I just invite you to look at these, your graduates, and to realize the influence and the effect that you have in their lives and will continue to have in their lives because of your example and your words of encouragement and praise. Dear graduates, so often when we have come together in this church, it has been for prayer, but it's also been for moments of discussion and other opportunities, whether it was to celebrate someone's sacraments or to celebrate a happy or maybe even a sad occasion. On Mondays when we've come together, we have had the opportunity to pray the novena to the miraculous medal. And as a gift to you, I'd like to offer a miraculous medal to each of you. I entrust it to Ms. McManus to be distributed and handed out to you when that is possible. But know that each medal has been blessed, and I encourage and invite you to wear it, as so often we said together the consecration prayer to the miraculous medal. I offer it with you at this moment. O Virgin Mother of God, Mary Immaculate, we dedicate and consecrate ourselves to you under the title of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. May this medal be for each one of us a sure sign of our affection for us and a constant reminder of our duty toward you. Ever while wearing it, may we be blessed by your loving protection and preserved in the grace of your Son. O most powerful Virgin, Mother of our Savior, keep us close to you every moment of our lives. Obtain for us, your children, the grace of a happy death, so that in union with you, we may enjoy the bliss of heaven forever. Amen. And as you wear your medal, know that it should be a constant reminder of this place, of your home here at Our Lady of Grace. For on the front of the medal is an image of Our Lady of Grace, as depicted in our chapel, and on the back, surrounded by 12 stars, signifying the apostles, are the Sacred Heart and the Immaculate Heart of Mary, which we have at each window on the side of the altar. On this Pentecost night, we come with the realization that the Lord always invites us to grow deeper in our faith, but he also gives us the graces and the blessings that we need in order to succeed, to fulfill the mission that he gives us. And so, on this Pentecost night, I invite you to join with me as I pray over you and pray over our assembly, so that the Spirit of the Lord may descend upon each of you as you embark on your new journey in life. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. And may God bless you, and may you continue to enjoy these days and festivities with great peace.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening, everyone. At this time, I would like to introduce Mr. Joseph Ferranti, who will be giving our family and friends a graduation blessing.
Many people helped us get to this special day, but none are more important than our parents and guardians. You sacrificed to send us to Catholic school. You listened and helped us when we were unsure, and you loved us even during the times that we might have challenged you. You were there to support us every step of the way. We are here today as the graduating class of 2020 because of your guiding hands, loving hearts, and encouraging words. We thank you and we love you.
I would now like to introduce to you the student who ranked second in class of 2020, our salutatorian, Luca Menka.
Good evening, Father Mark, Ms. McManus, faculty, family, friends, and the class of 2020. My name is Luca Menko, and I stand before you filled with pride, not only as your student council president, but also as the salutatorian of the class of 2020 of Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy. My fellow graduates, what a year we have had. We have been faced with more challenges than any other graduating class in history. Words like social distancing, remote learning, pandemic, and Zoom all became synonymous with the year 2020, but the word that describes us most is resilient. Not only did we make it through the pandemic, but together we crushed it. Whether it was a phone call, a text, or a Fortnite game, we leaned on each other and supported one another through the difficult times, and that's really the true meaning of friendship. While none of us envisioned the virtual graduation, here we are. Either way, tonight is a celebration. It's a time to celebrate each and every one of us and all of our achievements. 10 years ago, I began my journey at OLGCA with most of the same friends that graduated with me today. Along the way, we gained some new classmates, which only made us better. Together, we have grown, both as individuals and as a class. We were known as a spirited class, the class with a lot of personality, where none of us shied away from competition. Throughout the years, OLGCA has become my home away from home, and the people in it have become my family. I have been blessed with some of the best teachers that a student could ever ask for, and I will miss them all. Mr. Noon, I truly enjoyed all of our sports talks, and by the way, real men definitely do wear knee socks. Miss Jacqueline, I would think of you every time I hear the word Jeopardy, and trust me, Alex Trebek has nothing on you. Miss Amusa, thank you for making learning fun and for allowing me to express myself through my writing. Because of you, I am a better student. Mr. D, thank you for treating us like young adults and for always giving us the benefit of the doubt. I will miss all of your funny stories. I'd like to thank my parents and my family for making me who I am today. Thank you for making a sacrifice and a decision to send me to a Catholic school like OLGCA, where I have been given such a strong foundation. Mom and Dad, you are both my role models. Thank you for loving me unconditionally. Your constant support is what keeps me going and makes me want to be a better person. I am proud to be your son. Everyone who knows me knows that soccer is my passion, and I am so lucky to have so many people who encourage me and support me throughout my journey. I promise you that you're all invited to my first pro game. To my boys, my OLG soccer teammates, some of my best memories were on the pitch with all of you. I just wish that we could have played one more game together. To my fellow student council members, I am so proud of us. Together, we did some really great things and contributed to so many great causes. I am honored to have served our school with each of you. In September, I will be attending Archbishop Malloy with my brother Trentino, who will be a senior. And although I know that he will show me the ropes, moving on is still so bittersweet. As I prepare to move forward, I will look back fondly on all of the memories of OLGCA. Class of 2020, remember that we are the class who made history. Our year may have been cut short, but our dreams have not. The world is ours for the taking, so let's go out and make everyone proud. Congratulations to my fellow graduates. May God bless each one of you, and God bless America.
To the legendary graduating class of 2020, there are no words to express this crazy and unimaginable COVID-19 pandemic that has shaken the world. We know this has taken away your expectations as to what you had hoped your last few months of grade school would be filled with.
Maybe you're feeling the disappointment of missing your 8th grade trip, your 8th grade dinner, a live graduation in church, shaking hands with Mr. D, Ms. McManus, Father Mark, as you receive your diploma. Hugs and kisses from your family, friends, and classmates.
Look at the bright side. You got to virtual learn at your own pace. You became a pro at Google Classroom, Zoom, and FaceTime. In the comfort of your own home, and probably had the chance to play outside more than you would if you were in school.
You probably memorized hearing Governor Andrew Cuomo's voice on television every day at 11:30 a.m., and you have learned new phrases like social distancing, global pandemic, flattening the curve, and Dr. Fauci.
Today is your day, your moment to be proud of your accomplishments. You are a survivor, truly one of a kind, resilient, strong, amazing, and you are the future. Remember that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you.
You are the memorable class of 2020. You and your year will never, ever be forgotten. Hashtag graduation 2020. It has been a pleasure and an honor to educate you at Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy. You will always hold a special place in our hearts. May God bless you and guide you in your new journey.
Our Lady of Grace, pray for us. Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy, stay strong.
It is the privilege of the Board of Trustees to confer the diplomas on the class of 2020 and to congratulate the graduates on their achievements and all those who supported them. Having successfully completed the course of study prescribed by the state of New York and the Roman Catholic Diocese of Brooklyn, the following students are awarded a diploma. Please stand when you hear your name. Giovanni Bilo. Marco Bilo. Charlotte Sally Burridge. Antoinette Catherine Campanella. Juliet Brooke DeCandia. Marco Vincent Diaz. Joseph Michael Ferrante. Erica Bios. Ethan Intriago. Jessica Liberto. Valeria Lombardo. Jacqueline Lowenhoff.
Colin Klinger.
Luca Antonio Menko. Kayla Victoria Miller. Aiden Antonio Montalvo. Jade Ochoa. Matthew Frank Peppa. Michael Angelo Portella. Teresa Ryder. Victoria Ann Sicente. James Robert Savino. Jaden Safari Stewart. Anthony Charles Cafferone.
Michelle Tokar.
Graduates. The turning of the tassel is a joyful symbolism. The rotation of the tassel from one corner of the mortarboard indicates the successful completion of your academic studies here at Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy. To signify that you are graduates of Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy, please move your tassel from right to left. Ladies and gentlemen, I present the newly graduated class of 2020. Graduates, please remain standing to recite your graduate's pledge, which will be led by Charlotte Burridge.
Lord Jesus, we are here for the last time as a group from Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy.
As our last prayer together.
We thank you for guiding us through our years at this school.
As graduates of Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy,
we have found knowledge
of both God and humankind.
Help us to continue to come into your presence freely.
As often as we have in our past years as a class,
may all that we study in the future
be as helpful in bringing us closer to you
as it has been at Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy.
We are happy to have attended the school,
which has been an inspiration to us.
We ask your blessing
for those who taught us and for our future.
Lord, strengthen us
in our attempt to carry on your work
for the rest of our lives.
Fill us, the graduates of Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy,
with your unending power of grace and love.
so that each of us may fulfill the roles
which has been assigned to us in life.
We ask this of you,
who live and reign with God the Father,
in unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen.
I would now like to recognize the student who has achieved an overall average of a 93 to a 96.4 for the year. The achievement is symbolized by the silver cord. Please stand when your name is called. Michael Portella. The following students have achieved an overall average of a 97 to 100 for the year. This achievement is symbolized by the gold cord. Please stand when your name is called. Victoria Sicente, Luca Menko, Marco Bilo, Jacqueline Lowenhaupt, Colin Klinger, Jessica Liberta, Juliet DeCandia, Charlotte Burridge, Joseph Ferranti, Valeria Lombardo, Aiden Montalvo, Antoinette Campanella. I would like to acknowledge the following students who have received awards this year. The General Excellence Medal is awarded to Victoria Sicente. The Mathematics Medal is awarded to Luca Menko. The English Language Arts Medal is awarded to Colin Klinger. The Science Medal is awarded to Jessica Liberto. The Social Studies Medal is awarded to Joseph Ferranti. The Religion Medal is awarded to Juliet DeCandia. The Italian Medal is awarded to Valeria Lombardo. The Art Medal is awarded to Aiden Montalvo. The Physical Education Medal is awarded to Luca Menko. The Technology Medal is awarded to Michael Portella. The Integrated Algebra Medal is awarded to Marco Bilo. The Principal's Medal for Outstanding Academic Excellence and Strong Christian Values is awarded to Antoinette Campanella. For her dedication to Our Lady of Grace Church and Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy, the Christian Service Medal is awarded to Charlotte Burridge. The Merit Medal is presented to a student who has demonstrated overall improvement and growth. This year, the award is presented to Erica Fios. Every year, we recognize a student at the Academy who embodies the school spirit with constant enthusiasm each day. This year, our School Spirit Medal is awarded to Anthony Caffarone. The St. Francis Xavier Medals are offered in honor of Pope Francis and are awarded to students who best exemplify the ideals of a Jesuit education. This year, the medals are awarded to Colin Klinger and Valeria Lombardo. The Office of the State Controller Achievement Award is bestowed to two students in recognition of their hard work, dedication, and success. This year, the certificates are awarded to Joseph Ferrati and Jessica Liberta. The Triple C Award is given to two students by the Attorney General of the State of New York, who show commitment, character, and courage in bettering themselves, achieving their goals, and meeting the challenges ahead. This year, the certificates are presented to Juliet DeCandia and Luca Menka. The Ursuline Award is given in recognition of the Ursuline Sisters' 75 years of educating the students of Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy. This award is presented to a student who makes a difference in society by embodying the Ursuline mission of witness by life profoundly rooted in God. This award is presented to Charlotte Burridge. The Kiwanis Club of Howard Beach would like to recognize two students who have shown strong character and leadership potential while enrolled at Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy. This year, the award is presented to Marco Bailo and Victoria Sesenti. The DeCandia Family JDRF Scholarship, in honor of Jacob Levine, recognizes a student who is dedicated to family and school and exemplifies character and determination. This year's award is presented to Anthony Caffarone. I would now like to recognize the following students who have been awarded full or partial scholarships to Catholic high schools. Giovanni Bailo, Cathedral Preparatory School and Seminary. Antoinette Campanella, Holy Cross. Juliet DeCandia, Holy Cross. Marco Diaz, Cathedral Preparatory and Seminary. Joseph Ferranti, Monsignor McClancy. Jacqueline Lowenhop, Archbishop Molloy High School.
Lord Jesus Christ, we praise and thank you for our students, whom you have given us to teach and cherish. Surround them with your tender, loving care. Teach them to love and serve one another in true affection, and to look to you in all their needs. We place them in your care, knowing that your love for them is greater than our own. Keep us close to one another in this life, and conduct us at last to our true and heavenly home. Amen.
Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy is built on the tradition of academic excellence and Catholic faith formation, set forth by Our Lady of Grace Parish for over 80 years. We are dedicated to our Blessed Mother, and as a school community, we understand her role as our mother. We pray the Rosary and know that Mary intercedes on our behalf with her Son, Jesus. To honor Mary and the memory of Our Lady of Grace Parish, I now invite Jessica Liberto to come forward and present flowers to our Blessed Mother.
I would now like to introduce to you the student who ranked first in the class of 2020, our valedictorian, Victoria Sesenti.
It is my honor and privilege to be the valedictorian for the graduating class of 2020, and it is a pleasure to welcome each and every one of you. To our principal, Ms. McManus, our pastor, Father Mark, teachers, staff, parents, families, friends, and fellow graduates, welcome. Graduation is a time for moving on, but it is also a time of reflection. It is to reflect on our time here at Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy, a time well spent. Ms. McManus, you always manage to keep us on the right path, and you have been there to mentor us. Thank you for your guidance and all that you have done for us and all that you continue to do for Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy. Father Mark, you have always kept our Catholic faith deep within each and every one of us and made it a core value. We thank you for that. To our amazing teachers, It is you that we have to thank for the strong foundations our high schools of choice will inherit. Your class instructions, the countless projects, and let's not forget those wonderful Jeopardy assignments that built this foundation. A foundation that made us the students we are today. The curriculum was intense and a bit crazy, but not to make us trip and fail, but to challenge us towards excellence and to keep progressing towards the students and the graduates you see before you. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts. I know we're not easy to deal with at times, but you did it with excellence. To our wonderful, loving parents, who sacrificed so much so that we can have the best education and keep moving forward towards our dreams. Thank you for all that you do for us. It is greatly appreciated. The year 2020 will bring us great memories of our graduation. Even though we missed out on some of our memorable events, we still had many others to be grateful for. Unfortunately, it is a time of uncertainty and change. Changes in economy, changes in how we attend school, go to work, and gather socially. We needed to adapt quickly and find another way. Ms. McManus, you and our teachers did just that. We continue to learn and complete our studies remotely without any interruption. A credit to you and our teachers. An amazing achievement. Thank you for making it possible and making it work smoothly. In order to know where you are going, you need to know where you have been. We all know that our time here got us to where we are today. There's a possibility that we may very well begin high school remotely, but it will not be new to us because of the groundwork had already been set up for us to succeed in this new way of learning, thanks to everyone. To my friends and fellow graduates, we did it. The day has finally arrived. Nothing is going to be in our way of celebrating this special day, which we certainly deserve. We have developed a special bond that will last a lifetime. We've had so much fun along the way. Laughs, challenges, and most importantly, close friendships, which will be cherished. I would like to wish each and every one of you happiness and success in everything you do. In conclusion, the graduating class of 2020 accomplished so much. We are the perfect vision for success, and we are headed for greatness. You will not be disappointed. May God bless us and watch over us as we continue on our journey towards our next milestone. Thank you.
Congratulations to the graduating class of 2020. As eighth graders, you have completed the first leg of your journey towards high school. Many years ago, you began in pre-K or kindergarten. If you think about those memories, you had an opportunity over the past 9 years to grow as a person. You've grown in knowledge, you've grown in wisdom, but most importantly, you've grown in faith. As you continue your journey, this graduation, June 2020, will be unlike any other in the history. You will be graduating remotely. You'll be moving on to high school in a different way. However, as you look at what you have accomplished much because of the support of your parents and family. Graduation is a very special time, and it's a special time for you to learn and to be able to adapt. We all know over the past 3 months, we've had to make many changes in our lives. You, as eighth grade graduates, have had the opportunity to learn through distance learning. You've had the opportunity to continue your friendships, either through Facebook or through Instagram. You've also had the opportunity to grow with family. As we prepare for this graduation, it's a time for you to prepare for your next part of your life, that is high school. As you look to high school, you look to the new friends that you will meet. You will look to the new things that you will learn. But most importantly, you'll be rooted in the faith and the wisdom and the knowledge that you gathered in early childhood, elementary, and middle school. Graduation allows us to take a huge step forward. It allows us to reflect on what was given to us. As you gather this graduation day, think of the teachers that you've had along the way. Which of those teachers have made a difference in your life? Think about the principal, how he or she have guided you. Think of your parish priest, how they have continued to build in you your faith. But most importantly, as you sit around for this graduation day, think of your parents. Think of the sacrifices that they have made for you. Think of all the things that they have done with you and for you. Your gratitude to your parents and your family is most important during these challenging times. So as you prepare for this graduation day and prepare to move to the next part of your life, remember, God has a plan for each of us.
The Holy Spirit will continue to provide us guidance and wisdom, and Jesus, our Savior, will walk with you along this journey. Congratulations, best wishes, much success in the future.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Graduates, congratulations. What a wonderful moment this is on your journey through school. I'm Bishop James Massa, the Vicar for Education, who represents all the Catholic schools and academies in the Diocese of Brooklyn and Queens. You're probably participating in this graduation ceremony on your computer or smart device from your home. Who would have imagined that your graduation from eighth grade would happen like this? But it is what it is. And remember the old saying, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Today we're making lemonade, and it doesn't taste all that bad. When my video segment began, you heard a song by Philip Phillips that came out when you were in the first grade, 7 long years ago. It's called, I'm Going to Make This Place Your Home. And it speaks about how important home is and the people who make the places where we live and where we study into an environment where we feel loved and cared for. Today we give thanks for your moms and dads, your grandparents and other relatives who've given you a home over these many years, and especially over these past 3 months of the quarantine. They are so proud of your accomplishments and so hopeful about the future that now opens up for you in high school. Be sure to thank them for giving you a place in the world. These family members make real the words of the song. If you get lost, you can always be found. Just know you're not alone, because I'm going to make this place your home. Thank you, moms and dads, grandmas and grandpas, aunts and uncles, brothers and sisters and cousins, and all those who love our graduates. Today marks your departure from another home, the school where you were given the precious opportunity to grow and learn in some of the most important critical years of your life. Catholic schools like the one you've been proud to call your home are concerned not just with developing skills in subject areas like science, engineering, and language arts. No, because of our love for Jesus and his little ones, the children, we Catholic educators are concerned about the development of the whole person. And that's why we staff our academies and schools with teachers like those who have helped to form you. Be sure to write and email them, thanking them for the terrific job they've done. Be sure to thank your principal and all the other teachers and teachers' aides, staff, and volunteers who've enriched your learning experience so that you would be prepared to take this next major step in your life. You know, the world can be a frightening place, as we've learned through this recent crisis. But remember the words, the lyrics from Philip Phillips. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons. They'll fill you with fear. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. We also have a saying from the Bible, perfect love casts out all fear. Today we say goodbye to teachers who have loved you with a near perfect love. Angels of God that they are, They've borne the message that you are a beautiful person who has much to give to this new world of ours. And whatever career path you follow, and whatever shape your future family life takes, you have much to give and so much love to receive. Around this time of the year, we also read Jesus' words to his disciples before he went home to the Heavenly Father. He says, "In my Father's house, there are many rooms, and I have prepared a place for you." It is our brother and Savior, Jesus, who can make any place a home for us if we continue to pray to him, welcome him into our lives, and follow his path. Graduates, today marks not an end, but a beginning, full of hope, full of promise, full of gratitude for the home you've been given by your families and by your school community. To quote St. Catherine, one of my favorites, "Be the person whom God meant you to be and set the world on fire." May God bless you and keep you in his loving care, now and always. Amen.
I'm gonna make this place your home.
I would like to once again congratulate the class of 2020 from Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy. This is certainly not how I anticipated addressing all of you this evening. I am just as sad as you are, as I'm being filled in the school's gym without any of your smiling faces in front of me. Although we may not be together physically, I know we are all together emotionally and spiritually. I know that this is definitely not how any of you anticipated your last few months at Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy to be. And certainly not how we would be celebrating all of you today. Your days at OLGCA were cut short, and I know that you're all feeling a bit of sadness and disappointment. Our world was overturned by a national pandemic, and our lives drastically changed. Some of you have been part of the OLGCA family since Mommy and me, and some joined a few years ago, and some this past year. You should all be proud of your hard work, perseverance, and sacrifices you have made throughout your time at OLGCA. It has been a blessing getting to know all of you the last 6 years. During the last 6 years, I have watched you grow academically and spiritually. I look upon you this evening and see wonderful things for all of your futures. The high schools you attend in the fall are lucky to have you. You are all filled with many opportunities to share ahead in your future. Take each opportunity and try with all of your hard work and determination to make it your own personal opportunities. Thank you to all the parents for sacrificing so much to put your children through Our Lady of Grace Catholic Academy and giving them the opportunity for a wonderful Catholic education. Your commitment and dedication will never be forgotten. To the graduates, I leave you with a few more words of advice. It is okay to be scared and nervous on your next steps going to high school and beginning a new chapter in your life. I can still remember the day I began a new chapter in my life. It was the summer of August 2014, and I was walking around by myself at the annual family festival. It was that night that four young ladies named Antoinette, Charlotte, Jessica, and Juliet came and introduced themselves to me. It was my first time as a principal, and I was walking around meeting new adults and children that would later become part of my extended family.
Although I was trying to act like I wasn't nervous or scared, those four girls never made me feel so at home. Always remember, there'll be that one old or new friend that will be by your side and ease your nervousness and uncertainty of whatever you are feeling at that moment in time. Always remember, you are braver than you believe, stronger than you think, and loved more than you know. The doors at OLGCA will always be open for you to come visit. You will always be part of the OLGC family. On behalf of the entire faculty and board members of OLGCA, I wish you lots of luck in high school, college, and in the future. Congratulations again on this wonderful accomplishment.
Hi, class of 2020 graduates. I'm so proud of all your accomplishments here at OLGCA. I wish you all the best in high school. Congratulations and stay strong.
Hi, graduates. It's Miss Amory from Pre-K C. Although your year has been cut short, our love for you has not. My wish for all of you is for all your hopes and dreams to come true. You all deserve it so much. Best of luck to you in high school. We will miss you. Congratulations, class of 2020. You'll go down in history.
To the 8th grade graduating class of 2020, I just wanted to say that I'm so proud of you and all of your accomplishments. Good luck in high school, and we hope to see you back at OLG soon.
Good morning, graduating class of 2020. This is Miss Frankie, your Italian teacher. I just wanted to let you know that I'm very, very proud of you, and congratulations, you finally made it. Bravissimi. I also want you to know that you are my new heroes. Most generation of students didn't have to go through such devastating times as a pandemic, but you did it. You rose above, and you did it with grace, with diligence, with intelligence, and toughness. Congratulations again. I wish you all the best in all of your future projects. Enjoy this day, and arrivederci.
Congratulations, 8th grade. I'm so proud of each and every one of you. I'm going to miss you so much in ELA class, especially belting out Take Me Home, Country Roads. Wish you nothing but the best, guys.
Hi, OLG graduates. Just wanted to say I'm so proud of all your hard work. I wish you all the best of luck in the future. Remember, study hard, always be yourself, and have fun. I'll see you soon.
Congratulations, 8th grade. I'm wishing you all a new beginning that puts you on the path to achieve your dreams. Good luck.
Hi, 8th graders. Just wanted to say congratulations to you all on your graduation. I am so proud of you. Best of luck in high school and all your future endeavors, and I hope that all of your dreams come true.
Hi, 8th grade, it's Miss Rowe. Well, it's been a rough couple of months, but you made it out of quarantine and now on to high school. Congratulations on your graduation. Always follow your dreams. God bless you, class of 2020.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Job well done, everyone. Good luck in the future and in high school. I just know you're all going to do such wonderful things in your life, and I can't wait to hear about all of them. Come back and visit us at OLG.
Hey, class of 2020. I just wanted to congratulate you on your graduation. You guys have done such a great job. I'm so proud of you. I wish you the best of luck in high school and luck, love, and happiness wherever life takes you. Mrs. I will miss seeing you in the hall. Have a great summer.
To the OLGCA class of 2020, always remember you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. Congratulations on all your accomplishments. I hope you have so much fun in high school. I'll miss seeing your smiling faces at OLGCA.
To the 8th grade graduating class of 2020, congratulations on all your accomplishments. We are also very proud of you. Good luck in high school, and I hope to see you soon.
Hi, 8th grade. Congratulations. I'm so proud of all of you. I just wanted to say I'm really going to miss our Jeopardy games. You guys were always so competitive and so well prepared. I wish you nothing but the best of luck. Good luck in high school.
Hello, 8th grade. Well, this certainly was a different kind of year, but you made it through and you're all set to graduate. Remember what your Catholic education has taught you, to have faith and keep Jesus in your heart always. Congratulations and good luck in high school. Bye-bye.
Congratulations, 8th grade, you did it. You reached a milestone. I just want to say I'm very proud to have known all of you and to have been your teacher. Good luck and congratulations again.